In 1694, a Transylvanian mystic named John Calpius and his 40 followers sailed on a 5-month journey from England to the Germantown colony. They came to the New World to escape persecution for their occult practices. They soon moved from Germantown into the woods of the Wissahickon in caves overlooking the creek below. Somewhere near the caves, they built a 40-foot square log tabernacle. On the roof of the log cabin, they built the first observatory in the New World, where they watched the heavens above for signs. They soon became known by the locals as the Hermits of the Wissahickon. The Hermits believe at the turn of the 18th century, the world would come to an end. They believe that if they lived in the wilderness, a woman would save them. She would be clothed in the sun, the moon under her feet, and 12 stars above her head. The world didn't come to an end at the turn of the 1700s, and the enchanted woman never saved them. After years of preparation and patience, the hermits were finally disillusioned, and many of the members went their own way. However, the story of the mystic hermit John Calpius has more to it, for he is the one who gave us the name Roxborough. On May 25th, 1706, in a letter he wrote, he referred to his cave as the Burrow of Rocks because of the foxes that often burrowed into the rocky cellar of his cave. Later, when the area nearby became a township, the name Burrow of Rocks was changed to Roxborough, and so that's how the man once called Maddest of Good Men, John Calpius, gave us the name Roxborough. The cave that John Calpius used as a place of meditation still remains today, with a marker placed by the mysterious Rosicrucian Brotherhood. On a hike to photograph the Burrow of Rocks, I captured this strange apparition on film. Perhaps it's the spirit of Calpius still awaiting the arrival of the woman in the wilderness.